I can't believe I'm about to say that it sounds like The Simpsons sort of kickstarted the working career in the comics, which you would think that's sort of where you get over years, but it seems like everything sort of spanned after that.
Yeah, that's right. Because, so prior to that, I hadn't worked, I'd mainly magazine, kids magazine stuff that I'd done prior to that. So what's cool about The Simpsons, well, when you've worked on The Simpsons, you can put that in when you're like contacting other publishers. You go, oh, brother, I worked on The Simpsons. Here's some samples of my work. That's going to help, right? Yeah. I think what it does do is they'll at least read your email.
Mm.
Do you know what I mean? That they will at least, okay. It has this, puts up this facade that if you've done this, you know what you know something.
Well, it's the foot in the door that you were speaking about earlier. It's getting you the foot in the door, and that's all you needed. Right. As soon as you get it, you're going through.
Yeah, exactly right. Yeah. So that's what I've done, and that's what I've done with every other work since. Really, I've led with that. I've targeted publishers that publish the kind of style of work that I draw, because it's silly of me. It would be stupid to go, oh, I want to work for Marvel when I just don't draw that way. So that's been a bit of a take-home message for other creators. Like, make sure that what you do kind of fits, because it just pisses somebody off if it doesn't, what it hasn't done, what it's been interesting, I was sold into the lie that it's a snowball effect, that, oh, you get this gig, and then it kind of just builds on, and then you'll get this gig and this gig, and it'll just go like that. But that didn't, even with The Simpsons, that didn't happen. I had to purposefully contact publishers. Rick and Morty, I did a Rick and Morty cover, and it took me like 4 years of contacting on and off to actually get something. And I think one of the downsides of being in Australia is that you can't, you're not at the conventions all the time. You're not at the bar afterwards having a chat to ex-editor, because that's how you kind of get work. It's not the only way to get work. Yep. But the comic industry, I think, in the States is certainly smaller than we imagine it is. So I think, first, you don't want to piss anybody off because people are going to know. But also, people, generally speaking, want to work with people that they like and that they know are reliable, that type of thing. But you don't, you're kind of at a disadvantage when you're just an email.